Hey, this is Catalog Tracks. I'm making another video. I just wanted to let everybody know that I did make a new download available for everybody. So if you go to the YouTube page, you'll see I posted a comment on the community section. And it's basically an update to let everybody know that there was an update made to the template. One of the customers reached out to me. He was having problems. And, you know, I just re-uploaded this template recently. So there were some things that I forgot to fix up. And so I just want to make sure everybody's, that's not holding anybody up, or everybody else was able to get over that and they were able to use the template. And if not, you can re-download. Anytime I make an update or anytime you purchase, you can download as many times as you choose. And anytime there's an update, it just updates that file and then you re-download, it'll get that update. Also, we made a drum kit today, but I want to show you the little update that we did. It's just something real quick. When you load up my template, it should look like this. And sometimes when some people load the template up, it might give you an error message. It might say that there was a plugin missing and there was a sample missing. It's because I had a sample from, I think it was my beat tag sample, that was included on the template. And also in the mixer, I've tried to clear these out, but I must have left it on this new update that I did. And basically, it was a plugin right here, over here in the... In the sins. I went ahead and took those off, and also renamed this track right here beat tag. This is the track where you should put your beat tag, just for reference. I probably should have put an audio track there, but just link it to track 25. It'll, or just make an audio track and always have it loaded up on your template. That's how I had it on mine. I had it always linked to 25, and it was a little sample of my beat tag. And then also we took off that plugin. It was just an external, a third-party plugin, and it was making it basically load a little slower. Lastly, when you open up Machine and my template, when you have the template, it should open up like this. You should be able to click on Machine right here. My machine is hurting. And this should open up like that. And from here, Machine's ready to go. On my template, by default, when you open it up, it wouldn't work, or when you push a button, it wouldn't do anything. It's because, remember, I've told y'all that we put Smart Disable on. It just takes the CPU down a little bit. You can see my CPU right here at about 9. I think when I turn Smart Disable on, it just dropped down to about 4. And so anytime you're trying to save CPU, or when you're doing big things, stuff like that can help a lot. So went ahead and turned that off so that anytime you load the template up, it's ready to go. It's just going to pop right up, no pop-ups, and you'll be able to just start clicking on Machine right away. Remember, when you click on Machine and it loads up, what it just loaded up was the Machine template. So the template's not just a Fruity Loops template, it's a Fruity Loops template, which you can see. It's also a Machine template. This Machine template's routed all the way into the mixer in Fruity Loops, so all the sounds are linked up. Also, all those little channel racks that we see right here on Fruity Loops, they're also linked up into the little drum pads right here and the sound pads right here in Machine. So we're all linked up together. But there's also the third piece, which is all the functions, because remember we have the start, stop, play, and all these other functions and buttons that we're doing. And then we're doing those with the Machine inside of MIDI mode, meaning that you'll switch Machine over to MIDI mode and then my template will pop up. It's all blue, it lights up real nice, and it has a lot of functions of its own. So we're using Machine functions, Fruity Loop functions, and my template functions all together on the Machine MK3. So just keep that in mind. And also I made a new drum kit. So let me just load the drum kit that we made, or that it's available. It's a free download today. If you watch the video, appreciate that. Just go on my page and you can download this free drum kit. And I'm gonna load it up this way because my machine is turned off. So I would load up the browser. And then inside of the browser, you should have a way to use the little knobs and get to your folder or your personal samples. I put mine right here. And then inside of that, I have two subfolders, FX and kits. And then we put the kits here. And today I just loaded up kit 202. I've made these kits over the years when I made beats, and I'm gonna start releasing them for everybody because it's a perfect addition to the template, because now you have the template. Now you have my kits that are linked up, routed to the template, and they all go hard. So I should have did that a long time ago, but we'll start today with these free ones. They'll be available for sale, but there's so many of them that I probably won't sell them for much. And all these sounds, these are sounds that I've downloaded and sounds that I've amassed from my personal library. So this is what you would call a recycled sound. But my library is so massive that I can only... Anytime I would make a beat, I'd have to find the best quality sounds, you know, to use for my drum kit. And that's what these were, the best out of the bunch. And we did that many days in a row. But I knew that we needed to keep those kits because they were so good. They were the best, remember? And some of those sounds, I wouldn't come across them often because my library is so massive. So here it is, man. Kit 202. Hell, I guess I could play it for the video a little bit. we'll need to switch over my audio setting so that you can hear it. So I have to switch over to this FLS ASIO, and I don't have my machine lit up, or I could probably play them a little faster. But we got the Rat Kick Classic, another dope ass kick, another kick, and another kick. I put all four kicks on the bottom channel, but we only have one channel for kicks here, so pick one. Usually you shouldn't use one kick, but whatever. Then you have snares, some dope snares right there. And then some, that's how I do it. I do kicks, then I do snares, then I do a row of hi-hats. And then I do an open hi-hat on 12. And then I do my cymbal up top as my percussion, my cymbal. That's all right. And then we have a little brim and some other sounds. All right, so just check it out. See how it works real easily with the template and how it loads up. It's all color-coded and lighted up, and these are a good addition. So go ahead, download this for free. Load it up with the template and see what you can make. Also, click re-download. Go to your email or just send me a email or a message that say that, hey, I need a re-download link. If you can't find the original link, or just go to my store, really, and click on there, and your previous customer is going to let you re-download the file. Or it'll let me send that file to you. All right, man. Till next time. Appreciate it.